Welcome to another edition of Secrets of the Super Rich Friday. I'm your host, Tim McNeely, and wow, am I excited that you are here today. We're going to be talking about something super important to you, stress testing, putting your plans through their paces. And I love stress testing. It's something I've done in my life, and it's something I want to encourage you to do also. And by the end of our time together, you're going to know why stress testing is so important for your financial well-being and for accelerating your success even more. You're going to have a framework for how you can do this stress testing. And more importantly, you're going to feel confident about moving forward and doing a stress test in your own life. So let's dive right in. Let's get started. What are your key takeaways? Well, stress testing is a systematic way that you can really evaluate whether the financial and other expertise you use is likely to deliver the results you want. And we deliver a lot of super rich strategies, right? Coming down from the super rich to you that you can implement too. And 80% of single family offices, these are the structures used by the super rich, have done a stress test in the last 5 years. And your own stress testing efforts, they can be comprehensive. You can look at your entire picture, or they can just be focused on one or two aspects of your financial life. And when you do thorough wealth planning, when you implement a financial tool, a product, a strategy, you may end up with something unexpected or a disappointing result. Why? Because maybe something about that strategy you implemented has changed. Maybe there's been a new law that's passed, or it's possible that something occurred in your own life that made this current strategy inefficient or less than ideal for you. Let's face it, life as you know it is not static. Life changes all the time. So let's get in and let's really get into this content. So stress testing, right? Putting your plans through their paces. We mentioned 80% of single family offices are doing stress testing. And the reason they really do this is they want to ensure their family, that your family is getting the best possible results. Well, consequently, one objective is to work with the best of the best. The single family offices want the best team members. They want the top talent, and you do too. These professionals may be employed by the single family office, or they may be external experts who are engaged to address a specific matter for this family. But there's some complications. There's times when these single family offices are not working with the best of the best. Sometimes they end up with working with advisors that I call pretenders. These are well-intentioned professionals who are just not technically proficient as the circumstances require. You may have some of those pretenders in your plans too. And that's where stress testing can come in. This stress testing approach can help you systematically evaluate whether those financial and other expertise that your family is engaging is going to deliver the results that you expect and that you are wanting to achieve. And stress testing really is a popular approach among the super rich. Once again, in our survey and the research I helped underwrite, we find that 80% of the single family offices in the last 5 years, well, they have engaged in stress testing. And this is so important for you to grasp, right? You don't have to be extremely worried that something is amiss with your strategy before you engage in stress testing. In my life, we had an issue where she was facing a potential disability. And it was at that moment we started stress testing our plans. And man, was that stressful, right? Not just looking for errors in our plan, but also during a time in our life when there was a lot of stress going on. And the big lesson I learned about that is I wish I would have done it earlier. I wish I would have done it before we were in crisis. And that's what I want to encourage you to do. That's what I encourage my clients to do, is do the stress testing before you are in the midst of something. It's going to be so valuable for you to have peace of mind knowing that you've addressed these things before you are in a crisis. Now, when we get to stress testing, there's actually two types of stress testing that you can do. The first is what's called comprehensive stress testing. And during a comprehensive stress test, it's going to involve all the aspects of your financial and not financial life. For stress testing to be comprehensive, there's really three or more particular sets of services or products that you should assess, right? You really want to do that comprehensive look. In contrast, the other type of stress testing is focused stress testing. This is going to be fewer than three sets of services or products that have been done in the same 18-month period. And often, you're just going to stress test one part of your plan. The comprehensive, much more involved, very time consuming, very costly than just doing focus stress testing. In contrast, though, that focus stress testing, much more targeted, less expensive, and time intensive. And you may just have one or two things that you want to stress test. You may say, what's going to happen if I get hit by that proverbial bus? Do I have my estate plan in place? Or you may say, what happens if I sell my business? What's going to happen? How do I minimize taxes on that? And it's interesting, when you look at the number of stress tests done and the approach, the vast majority, 98%, are focused stress testing, right? They really do the focus. They focus on just a couple things. Now, what are the results of the stress test? What are some of the faults? What are some of the issues that may come up? Because that's the goal of you doing a stress test, is you want to identify errors and missed opportunities. And it turns out that when you do a stress test, these things happen fairly regularly. In fact, once again, going back to the research I want to share with you, more than 40% of single family offices found faults because of their stress testing. Clearly, mistakes occur, even among top professionals. And if the family offices are working with the best of the best individuals and they're catching fault 40% of the time, what's going on in your current financial plan? If you're not working with the best of the best, those numbers have the potential to be much, much higher. But thanks to stress testing, you can potentially fix these problems before they get serious. And it's really important for you to keep in mind that stress testing does extend beyond just wealth management and related legal matters. It can apply to lifestyle decisions. It may apply to changing states or getting out of California. Those may be things you want to look at and consider as you move forward. And then lastly, I can hear you saying, what's that? You don't have a single family office? You're not a multi-millionaire? You're not a billionaire? Well, that's okay, because you can still engage in stress testing to help you determine whether or not your wealth management solutions remain on target to deliver you the desired results. And you can still use stress testing to see if there's any opportunities that you currently aren't taking advantage of, but that you should. This is something that comes right out of the playbook of the super rich. This is a super rich strategy that I want to share with you on Super Rich Fridays. And if you take this, if you go back and you really put some, many, or even all of your aspects of your financial life through their paces to make sure that everything's set up to do what you want it to do and deliver the results you're going to expect, if you take this step and you engage in stress testing, you really will be following in the footsteps of some of the wealthiest, most successful families, the super rich. Now, if you do these strategies, if you go back, whether it's comprehensive or focused, if you start stress testing your plans and catching those errors before they're big errors, you're going to make it a great day. I'm Tim McNeely. I'm in your corner. I'll see you again next Friday for Secrets of the Super Rich.